हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5 ऑफ क्लास 7 सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश टू प्रोनाउंस। वी मे से टीना इज एब्सेंट बिकॉज टीना इज इल, बट इट इज बेटर टू अवॉइड द रेपिटेशन ऑफ द नाउन टीना एंड सेम। टीना इज एब्सेंट बिकॉज शी इज इल। व्हाट आर द प्रोनाउंस? प्रोनाउन इज अ वर्ड वी यूज इंस्टेड ऑफ अ नाउन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ वी आर सेइंग द नेम ऑफ सम पर्सन, वी कैन यूज he or she for that person if in the same sentence we have to just repeat the name of that person. A word that is thus used instead of noun is called a pronoun. There are different kinds of pronouns. Look at the table given below. Personal: me, you, she, he, it, we, us. Possessive: mine, yours, hers, their, sorry, his, theirs. Reflexive: emphatic: myself, yourself, herself. Relative: who, whom, whose, which, what. Interrogative: who, whom, whose, which, what. Demonstrative: the, that, these, those. Indefinite: all, another, any, everyone, none, some. Distributive: each, either, neither. Personal pronouns: read the following sentences. I am young, we are young. You are young, you are young. He, she, it is young. They are young. The pronoun I and we, which denote the person or people speaking, are said to be the personal pronoun of the first person. Next, the pronoun you, which denotes the person or people spoken to, is said to be a personal pronoun of the second person. The pronouns he, she, and they, which denote the person or people spoken about, are said to be the personal pronoun of the third person. It, although it denotes the thing spoken about, is called the personal pronoun of the third person. I, we, you, he, she, it, they are called personal pronouns because they stand for the three persons: the person speaking, the person spoken to, and the person spoken about. Note: you is used both in the singular and plural. Definition: a pronoun such as mine, yours, or theirs, which is used to refer to the thing of a particular kind that belongs to someone, is a possessive noun. Possessive noun: possessive noun shows that something belongs to someone. The possessive pronoun are mine, your, our, yours, his, her, hers, and their. Example: this book is mine, those books are yours. That book is hers, that idea of yours is excellent. Exercise 1. Complete the sentence with the correct form of pronoun. Rama and Dash were present. Rama and I were present. You are smaller than him. I know that it was she. He is taller than me. Let you and Dash try what we can do. I. Sixth one: you know that as well as I. We are not so poor as they. Rama is as old as. So it is me. He is known to my brother and me. They are far better singers than us. Whom can I trust if not him? Let Dash, you can answer this question. Let he, who can answer this question. Reflexive pronouns: when self is added to my, your, him, her, it, and selves to our, your, them, we get what are called compound personal pronouns. They are called reflexive pronouns when the action done by the subject turns back reflects upon the subject, as I hurt myself, we hurt ourselves, you will hurt yourself, you will hurt yourself, he hurt himself, she hurt herself, the dog hurt itself, they hurt themselves. A reflexive pronoun is a pronoun such as myself, yourself, herself, which refers back to the subject of a sentence or clause. It will be noticed that each of these reflexive pronouns is used as the object of a verb and refers to the same person or thing as they denoted by the subject of the verb. Note, emphasizing pronouns cannot start alone as subject. It is therefore incorrect to say wrong. Myself saw him to do it. Right. I myself saw him to do it. Emphatic pronouns. Now look at the following sentences. I will go it myself. I myself saw him to do it. You yourself can best explain. She herself says so. I was told so by the teacher himself. The town itself is not very large. They themselves admitted their guilt. Definition. Personal pronoun, myself, yourself, herself, that are used for the sake of emphasis are called the emphatic or emphasizing pronouns. Next, exercise 2. Underline the pronoun in the following sentences. Then write R for reflective pronoun and E for emphatic pronoun. The dog choked itself. So underline the word itself and write R. We seldom see ourselves as others see us. So you have to underline the word our self and write R. A house divided against itself cannot stand. So underline the word itself and write R. Axiphus himself was the last to cross the Hellespont. So underline the word himself and write E. I myself heard his remarks. So underline the word myself and write E. He himself said so. Underline the word himself and write E. Now, demonstrative pronouns. Note the following sentences. This is a present from my uncle. These are merely excuses. Both the cars are costly, but this is better than that. Mumbai mangoes are better than those of Bangalore. Make hazard. That's a good boy. Here, that equals to one who makes hazard. There was no period in ancient India history so glorious as that of the Guptas. Do not write as the Guptas. I may have offended, but such was not my intention. It will be noticed that the pronoun in italics are used to point out the objects to which they refer and are therefore called demonstrative pronouns. Latin demonstrate, which means to show clearly. This refers to what is close at hand and nearest to the thought of or person of the speaker, that refers to what is over there, farther away and more remote. This is better than that. That with its plural, those is with used to avoid the repetition of a preceding noun, as the climate of Belgium is like that of Pune. The rivers of America are larger than those of Europe. Definition. This, that, etc. are called demonstrative adjectives when they are used with nouns, as what was that noise, this horse is better than that horse. All such people ought to be avoided. Now, indefinite pronoun. Consider the following sentences. All these pronouns in italics refer to the people or things in a general way. Note, none is a shortened form of not one, yet it is commonly used with plural verbs. Definition. Pronouns that refer to people or thing in a general way but do not refer to any person or thing in particular are called indefinite pronoun. Note, the indefinite pronoun one should be used throughout if used at all. Most of these words may also be used as adjectives. I will take you there one day. Any fool can do that. He is man of few words. Some milk was split. Worst. One hardly knows what to do. One cannot be too careful about what one, not he or she, says. One cannot be too careful of one's, not his or her, good name. One must use one's best efforts if one wishes to succeed. None of his poems are well known. None but fools have ever believed it. They, people in general, say he has lost heavily. All were drawn. Some are born great. Somebody has stolen my watch. Nobody was there to rescue the child. Few escaped unhurt. Many of them were Gurkhas. We did not see any of them again. One or other of us will be there. Do good to others. Did you ask anybody to come? What is everybody's business is nobody's business. His words are in everyone's mouth. In referring to anybody, everybody, everyone, anyone, each, etc., the pronoun he or she is used according to the context. As, I shall be glad to help every one of my boys in his studies. When the sex is not determined, we can use the pronoun of the masculine gender, as there are no singular pronoun or the third person to represent both male and female. If anybody knows the truth, let him tell it. Everybody is discontent with his lot in life. Everyone likes to have his way. Anyone can do this if he tries. Each must do his best. Distributive pronoun. Consider the following sentences. Each of the men was paid rupees 50. Either of the two roads lead to the railway station. Neither of the accusation is true. Definition. Pronoun like each, either, neither, that consider members of a group separately rather than collectively are called distributive pronouns. Each, either, neither refer to the people or thing one at a time. Either or neither should be used only in speaking about two people or things. When more than two are spoken about, anyone should be used as has anyone of you a blue pencil? She was taller than anyone, not either of her five sisters. In the following sentences, each, either, and neither are used as adjective. They are followed by nouns of the singular number. Each boy took his turn. Neither accusation is true. At either end was a marble statue. His either equals to each or both. Exercise 3. Read the following sentences and say whether the italics pronouns are demonstrative, indefinite or distributive. So, the first one. None of his movies were super hit. So we will underline the word none and we will write indefinite. Okay? Indefinite. Second one, that is the India Gate. So we will just underline that and write demonstrative. Third one, that book is yours. Underline the word that and write demonstrative. Fourth one, one must not always praise oneself. So one is indefinite. Okay. Some are born great. So underline the word some and write indefinite. Sixth one, either of you can go. Underline the word either and write distributive. Next, these cow cost 1000 rupees each. So underline the word each and write distributive. Next, eight, the two women hate each other. So underline the word other and write indefinite. Next, the stranger is welcomed as such. Underline the word such and write indefinite. Last, our soldiers were better drilled than those of enemies. Underline the word those and write demonstrative. Demonstrative. Okay, now turn the page and you have relative pronouns. Read the following pairs of sentences. I met Ron. Ron had just returned. I had found the pen. I lost the pen. Here is the book. You lent me the book. Let us now combine each of the above pair into one sentence. Thus, I met Ron, who had just returned. I have found the pen which I lost. Here is the book that you can lend me. Now let us examine the work done by each of the words who, which and that. The word who is used instead of the noun Ron. It therefore does the work of the pronoun, though it also works as a conjunction. Such a pronoun is known as a relative pronoun. Now definition. A pronoun is called a relative pronoun when it refers or relates, that is, carries us back to some noun going before. This noun is called its antecedent. Work is always complete. Forms of relative pronoun. The relative pronoun who has different forms for accusative and possessive cases. Case: nominative, possessive, accusative. Who, whose, whom. Examples: this is the boy or girl who works hard. This is the boy or girl whose exercise is done well. This is the boy or girl whom all praise. These are the boys or girls who work hard. These are the boys or girls whose work is always complete. These are the boys or girls whom all praise. It will be noticed that the forms are the same for singular and plural, masculine and feminine. Be careful to use who, nominative, and whom, accusative, correctly. Note: in present day English, the relative pronoun who is often used instead of whom. Who can be used in the accusative case except in a very formal style. Example: who, not whom, they were, I really cannot specify. He was the man who, not whom, they determined should be the next mayor. One evening of each week was set apart by him for the reception of whosoever, not whosoever, choose to visit him. The student whom, not who, you thought so highly of has failed to win the first prize. The relative pronoun, which has the same form for the nominative and accusative cases. Example: this is the house which belongs to my uncle. This house which my uncle built cost him rupees 4 lakh. The relative pronoun, which has no possessive case, but those is sometimes used as a substitute for of which, as a triangle whose three sides are equal is called a equilateral triangle. The relative pronoun that has the same form of the singular or plural are and in the nominative and accusative, it has no possessive case. Example: he that is content is rich. They that touch pitch will be defiled. Take anything that you like. The relative pronoun what is used only in the singular and has the same form in the nominative and accusative. Example: what has happened is not clear. I say what I mean. He failed in what he attempted. Use of relative pronoun. As a general rule, who is used for people only. It may refer to a singular or a plural noun. Example: the man who is honest is trusted. They never fail who die in a great cause. Next we have whose. The possessive form of the who is used in speaking of persons, but sometimes of things without life. Example: the sun whose rays give life to the earth is regarded by some people as a god. This is the question whose solution has baffled philosophers of all ages. More properly, this is the question of the solution of which has baffled philosophers of all ages. Which is used for things without life and for animals. It may refer to a singular or a plural noun. Example: the monument which is lost forever. The dog which I recently bought is an Alsatian, which was formerly used to refer to the people as our father, which art in heaven, which may also refer to a sentence. Example: the man was said to be drunk, which was not the case. He said he saw me there, which was a lie. That is used for people and things. It may refer to a singular or a plural noun. That has no genitive case and it is never used with the preposition preceding. Example: this is the boy that I told of you of. I know the house that he lives in. Next, it will be noticed that the relative pronouns that is used only in the relative clause that restrict, limit or define the antecedents. In other words, the relative pronoun that has a restrictive fold. As the relative pronoun that has a restrictive fold, it sometimes becomes unsuitable as the substitute for whom or which. Thus, I cannot say, my father, that is a schoolmaster, is 50 years old. I must say, my father, who is schoolmaster, is 50 years old. The relative pronoun that is used in preference to who or which. After adjectives in the superlative degrees, as he was the most eloquent speaker that I ever heard, the wisest man that ever lived made mistakes. After the words all same nothing, the only as, all is not gold that glitters. He is the same man that he has been. It was not for nothing that he studied philosophy. Man is the only animal that can talk. After the interrogative pronoun, who, what, as, who am I that I should object? What is it that troubles you so much? After two antecedents, one denoting a person and the other denoting an animal or a thing, as the boy and the and his dog that had trespassed on the club premises were turned out. What refers to only two things only. It is used without an antecedent expressed and is equivalent to that which or the thing which. What equals to that which cannot be cured must be endured. I say what equals to that which I mean. What is one man's meant is other man's poison. What I had written, I have written. It will be noticed that what is used in the nominative and accusative singular only. In older English, the word as was used as a relative pronoun after such as. His answer was such as I expect him to give. Omission of the relative pronoun. The relative pronoun is generally omitted when it would be in the accusative case, as few and short were the prayers we said. Man must reap the things they sow. In the following examples from poetry, a relative pronoun in the nominative case is omitted. This distance lends entrenchment to this view. I have a brother is condemned to die. Omission of the antecedent. Sometimes the antecedents of relative pronoun was left out, as who works not shall not eat. This means he who works not shall not eat. Whom the gods love die young. This means those who the gods love die young. Agreement of the relative pronoun and its antecedents. When the subject of the verb is a relative pronoun, care should be taken to see that the verb agrees in number and person with the antecedent of the relative pronoun, as this is one of the most interesting novels that have not has appeared this year. He is one of the cleverest boy that have passed through the school. One of the greatest judges that have ever lived laid this down as law, and so on. Position of the relative pronoun. To prevent ambiguity, the relativity pronoun should be placed as near as possible to its antecedent, as the boy who won the first prize in English is the son of my friend Mr. Joshi. It would mean something quite different if we separate the relative pronoun from its antecedent and say, the boy is the son of my friend Mr. Joshi who won the first prize. Again, such a sentence as, I have read Gokhale's speeches, who was a disciple of Ranadi, would be improved if changed to, I have read the speeches of Gokhale, who was a disciple of Ranadi. So also the following sentence requires to be rearranged. I with my family resides in a village near Pona, which consists of my wife and three children. Pronouns of the third person plural should not be used as antecedents to whom and that, as they that are whole have no need of a physician. There those is to be preferred to they. Now coming to the exercise 4, we have complete the exercise with who, whom, whose, which or where. What's the name of द मैन डैश कैन बोरोड हुज अ पैसिफिस्ट इज अ पर्सन डैश बिलीव दैट ऑल वॉर्स आर रॉन्ग हु द प्लेस डैश वी स्पेंड द हॉलीडेज वॉज वेरी ब्यूटिफुल वेयर I don't know the name of the woman to dash I spoke on the phone. Whom? Ron and Jessica dash had got married last year, recently bought a new house. Who? Their new house dash they bought was quite cheap. Which? So you have to complete the exercises 1, 2, 3 and 4 on page number 29. 30, 31, 33 and 39. So complete your work in your textbook. Thank you.